Jehova Malak, Olam Olamat. Jehova Malak, Yahweh Rakesh. Jehova Gadol, Makari Antios. Jehova Adonai, Jehova Elohim. Kurios Theos Panta Kreta, Kurios Theos Pistos. Elda et Ehova, El Emana Yehova. Ivasilion Kurios, Otios, O Panta Kreta. Baslios, Baslion, Kai Kurios, Kurion. Yehova Dabar Halav. Elohim Dabar Halav. Yehova Elohim, Gadol Gadol Gebura. El Elohim Israel, Jesus Christos. Ton Christon, Isun Ton Kurion. Kurion Imahagion Pentecreta, Gadol Gadol Gebura. Yehova Ishman Kam. Yehova Shamma. El Nakum Yehova, El Nakum Yapa. Netzach Israel, La Sheker, Gava, Gava. Triembos Yehova, Jesus Christos, Panta Greta, Gadol, Gadol, Gebur. Mora Rosh Nasa, Elohim, Elohim. Ilela Yeshalut, Jehovah Malak, Jehovah Malak, Olam, Olam, Ad. Jehovah Eloheinu, Jehovah Echad, Gadol, Gadol, Gebur. Zaan Logan, Ogar, Tautios, Dulas, Desmias, Despotes. Dikaisune, En Isus Christos, Kurion, 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 Hagion, 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 Numa Pantecreta, Gadol, Gadol, Gebura. Jehova Ihe Elohim, Jehova Ihe Elohim, Ilelai Shalut, Jehova Malak, Jehova Malak, Olam, Olam, Ad. Jehova Eloheinu, Jehova Echad, Gadol, Gadol, Gebur. Jehova, Jehova El, Jehova. Jehova Rakum Shem. Jehova El, Arak Api, Rab, Keset, Emet. Jehova, Mine, Mine, Tiker, Ufarsin. Derek, Emuna Bakar, Mishpat Shava. The megalogai of Yahweh El Elyon Elohim is always alive and powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of the soul and the spirit and the joints and the marrow, and it is a critic of thoughts and intents of the heart. All scripture is God-breathed and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, and for instruction in righteousness, a training in righteousness, that the man of blood cut might be mature, thoroughly furnished unto all good works. Study to show thyself approved unto blood cut, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth, a very accurately handling this very great, unique, infallible, and inerrant great word of truth. Glory be to my Yahweh Sidkeno to the highest, and peace be unto the mankind on this earth. To those who believe in my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, by faith alone in Christ alone. Great goodness and goodwill towards them who love to walk breath by breath, in the cherishing and in this nurturing of this great and unique indwelling mentoring ministry of Lord God, the Holy Ghost. One more day, being renewed in our lives to the praise of Lord God's glory, to understand the people who they were kept earlier, the church, called as Jews, when Moses was being told by Joshua that Eldad and Medad were prophesying outside of the camp, and he desired that everyone in this camp also would prophesy, not only the 70 men, and keeping them as an example for the entire mankind, as I said in Amos chapter 3, leaving them and not anyone on the face of the earth. He teaches to us a very, very important lesson, how a Jew was to be in the Lord, how he turned out, and much more greater than that, the church. If the Jews have been taken up to be the tool of the Lord God, the church is called to be the wife of the Lord God. But at least let's resemble our life to look, are we at least like the people of Jews? The word Jews meant to say, taking up of Judea, praised. And they praised the glory of the Lord through a proper an act of worship given for them to do it, through the teachings of Moses, and given them to obey the commandments, so that when they disobey those minute laws or the blue laws, what we call in the Old Testament, they were disqualified. They would grieve and they would come back and once again pay those vows or sacrifices and come back to reconcile back. Even those rituals, what they have been told to perform, was very, very unique. And it would be very difficult for a man to perform those things. And he gave them, and there were some people who fulfilled it. But not, they couldn't fulfill the entire law. At least they could try to make it up 50-60%, not the entire 100%. Only Christ, the Lord of God, kept the entire 100% of the law. The summary of the two laws, loving your neighbor as you love thyself, and love your Lord your God with all your strength, soul, might, and power, so that first you seek his righteousness and his kingdom, then all these things will be added unto you. Teaching to us those things, effectively calling us to understand what they tried maximum to keep the terms and conditions of the word Jew, called as praised, rather than making up their life to bow down before the magnificent world in its lusts and in its power. And these Jews, in the past dispensation, set an example. Excuse me. At least few. We can be like the men like Daniel, along with his friends in chapter number 1, set apart from the worldly pleasures, sanctifying themselves so that they shall not defile their flesh in the terms of this earth. And Lord God rewarded them 10 times greater wisdom and knowledge. They were found to be more fit than the others. In all of these things, if you can look, he simply teaches to us what a great caliber of men we were, or we ought to be, in the terms and conditions of the power of Lord God, the Holy Spirit. Because how much you have been actually well determined to do the will of the great Lord God, the Father in heaven. So the Jews in the past were set an example. Now the present is the church age. Because with the Jews, he has to reach the entire world he thought of in the book of Isaiah chapter 41, which are reading. The present church age has been told, the great commission, go and make disciples of all the nations. You have no laxity in that. That means you cannot go to give your reasons or alibis or XYZs to say that. I will be in such a way, I will be in such a way. No, not at all. Your alibis, your excuses have been left out. Because the church has been now given the power of Lord God, the Holy Spirit, who is able to do and perform the will of God the Father. But now he calls everyone who believes in Christ. that whosoever believeth upon him shall never perish, but have an everlasting life. Such a great life you have been called. And yet, dear brethren, as Proverbs chapter 19, in verse number 10, we find this caliber and section of the people who say that delight is not seemly for a fool, much less for a servant to have rule over princes. So though you have been given to be wise and to be humble enough to rule over the prince of the power of this air, you people are still becoming fools and not able to do the will of the Lord. Because the word delight over here, when he calls, it is nothing but nuag, and the word meant to say deliciousness. The one who is a stupid, he will not come to know what it is. And that deliciousness he calls. The viewpoint in the vigor and valor is not been erected to the structure of Bible doctrine. So he says, deliciousness. Who? One is stupid. Who is a stupid? The one who hasn't grown up into grammatia's program because he has a lot of pressure. And that pressure makes him not to become as a qualified disciple to the Lord. So he says, deliciousness. The one who is a stupid, it is not seemingly fit for him. In his vigor and valor, there is no Aleph energy to enjoy that deliciousness because he's a stupid. The same thing today, what deliciousness you have in the fellowship of Lord God, the Holy Spirit, as compared to the lusts of the world in the flesh. It's not comely to you. It's not seemingly well to you because that doesn't give you your Aleph energy power. That doesn't drive your vigor and valor for that power. So he said, it is not comely. It is not worth for you. So, dear brethren, your deliciousness in the fellowship of Lord God, the Holy Spirit, what has been given for us in this church age, to rule and to have authority over the fallen angels and to make up your life to be in the fellowship of Lord God, the Holy Spirit, breath by breath, has been taken up, not even to be compared to the Old Testament Jews. Far less your rank is something high in the church age. Because you are not enjoying the real fellowship of Lord God, the Holy Spirit, breath by breath. Therefore it seemeth stupid. The people who will be stupid, their thought process will be under great pressure because they will not come to Grammatia's program. If they would grow up into Grammatia's program, they would simply go and make disciples of all the nations. And since the thought process has not been effective to the standards of Bible doctrine, so dear brethren, you can look and you can understand how much they have been still, to the core, stupid and not able to perform the will of the great Lord our God. Though the people try to weaken up, you have now something great for you in the church age, which goes to make up your life to be in the fellowship of Lord God, the Holy Spirit, to such an extent that you shall be like the light of fire. You shall be like that great light of fire. Not just light, but light of fire. Consuming of those things which are against the word of Lord God. You'll be such a great light of fire with the sight of Lord God, just to humbly obey the truth. But you know what we are doing and how we are failing? The pattern of the Jews, if you can look, they thought the word of Lord God is a light foot, says Numbers 21:5 in comparison with Numbers chapter 11. In verse number 5 and 6, they thought it's a light thing, it's a worthless thing, it's a baseless thing. They thought that manna was not able to provide them that great strength. The Jews failed by neglecting the word of God. Christians are failing by neglecting the mentoring ministry of Vladkar, the Holy Spirit, whose sole purpose is to make sure to lead you into nothing but all the truth in Christ. So, dear brethren, your life that you're living, if you're not enjoying the deliciousness of the powerful mentoring ministry of Vladkar, the Holy Spirit, that meant to say you're a fool, you're a stupid. Because no weapon that is formed against you will ever prosper, says the word in Isaiah 54:17. Then being stupid, being fools, it always inculcates and emphasizes the point to us that never you will grow up into grammatias. Never you will become the disciple-oriented believers to the Lord. And never you will have to understand that pressure in this angelic conflict to realize and to battle the Lord's mind. Because the Lord's mind is to make sure that you all grow up in grace and come back to the fellowship of Vladkar, the Holy Spirit. This is the Lord's mind. Since you're fools, you will not understand the deliciousness of the Holy Spirit. Your thought process will end up looking for miracles or healings, fake things. Being fed upon lies rather than truth. If the pastor teacher is preaching the truth for you, he has to well prepare you from the original Hebrew, Greek, and Aramaic. If he doesn't go to preach to you in those terms, then it meant to say he is telling you lies. Therefore, you will not understand the deliciousness of Vladkar, the Holy Spirit. And you make up the deliciousness of Vladkar, the Holy Spirit, in the terms of what we call over here as miracles or healings, but not accurate edification to become like God, as one among us, as he said in Genesis, to know the good and evil, and to refrain from evil, eschew the evil, grab in the truth and goodness, and walk in such mentoring ministry of the Holy Spirit. So, dear brethren, use the privacy of your priesthood to confess your sins through rebound. And let's come back and continue what Vladkar the Father has prepared and kept for us. On today's date of Advent past, to the praise of his glory, in his matchless, marvelous, infinite, divine, glorious grace. We shall continue after this prayer. Sanctify yourselves to look upon the great and unique pale wonders of the Lord's mind. Infinitely divine Holy Father, once again coming into the marvelous grace of Lord to learn thy truth. How many great things are there for us in the word of Lord, God of Lord, to study and to learn and to edify and to grow up. And yet, Father, we are not able to recognize your terms. Help us, O Lord, to realize your mind more accurately, to understand your truth more accurately, and to become that great caliber of your mind and thought, that we walk in nothing but your truth. So, Father, as we have come once again to study your mind in the fellowship of Vladkar, the Holy Spirit, for today's date of Advent past, we pray. The mentoring ministry of Vladkar, the Holy Ghost, enlighten and challenge and bless us by the message of yours, which thou hast kept for us on today's date of Advent past, to the praise of your glory, in your matchless, marvelous, infinite, divine, glorious grace. In Christ's name we ask, Sovereign Lord. Amen. In Esther chapter 3, looking into the example of the way how the Jews can be to the Lord, we find a man called as Mordecai, and he looked Mordecai is a man who doesn't bow down himself before Haman. And that triggers great wrath against Haman, against Mordecai. Because all the king's servants that were in the king's gate, they bowed to reverence Haman. Because the king had so commanded concerning him, but Mordecai did not bow down. Like the way our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ did not bow down to the alluring things of Satan, what it shows to him in Matthew chapter 4. We look over here in Matthew chapter 4, beginning with verse number 5. It says, verse number 8 it has to be. The devil taketh him up into an exceedingly high mountain and showeth him all the kingdoms of the world and the glory of them. And the word glory over here is called to be doxa. That means the judgment which you will get as a prize. And the word over here could be kabod. And that meant to say, if you fail to become like a grammatious program in your body, if you fail to get every thought into captivity for Christ, that glory, not the glory of getting every thought into captivity for Christ, as even 2 Corinthians chapter 10 goes on to chapter 6 goes on to teach, separating yourselves from the world and looking to be one with Christ. The same thing again we read in Jeremiah chapter 32. One mind, one spirit, making up the things pertaining to Lord God the Father, to get every thought. So he says, when you are away from such life, that means no grammatious program, not able to get every thought into captivity for my Christ, he said, that glory, that doxa, the doxa which has been obtained without the word of God, to look the things, a right thing which has to be done in the right way, but over here, a right thing being done in a wrong way. That means glory, but in a wrong way. The wrong way in the sense, no grammatious program, the wrong way in the sense, no getting every thought into captivity for Christ. That's the wrong way. So Satan shows, bow down to me, I will give you all the glory. And the first one over here, what we look is kabod. That means no grammatious program, not able to get your every thought in your body for the captivity for Christ. And then he further teaches to us, the fruit of your mouth, which has to be renewed. But now it is not a truly genuine renewed people. For example, how to tell you, over here on the earth itself, if you can find some of the examples in your life which you pass through, the people who backbited you, hated you, spoke evil against you, cheated you, tried an attempt to rape upon you, or whatsoever it may be. Them whom you never want to see back again. So you live a holy, righteous life, you're going up into the heaven, and if you find the same persons there, you will not understand the character, you will look. These were the same characters in the earth. They never refined themselves. So till the day when Judas Iscariot was about to die, he gives him a chance to repent. But he never changed. He never repented, except the son of perdition, says the word of God. That means he wanted to save all in his realm, except him. You have given everyone to me, O Lord. That meant to say what? He hasn't changed. Therefore we look, the same principle with every human being on the earth, so that now they have to come and give the fruit to the Lord with a true repented heart, not like Judas Iscariot, who felt that he has cheated, guilty, he felt guilty, but no true repentance, no true fruit from their lips. So the false glory, what Satan goes to promise to my Christ, first of all, it would say people will be over there with true genuinity, but getting their mouth not being renewed as per the word of the Lord God, they try to give you that glory. And Christ, the Lord of God, says he doesn't want such glory, a false glory, and not a true heartfelt repentance to the Lord. I don't want such false repentance. I want genuine repentance. So that he says, when they try to give you with such allurement, or making you to live your life in those terrors, he said, they will give you a great pleasure in your body. They try to make up their every thought as if they're obeying you. And that's what Satan talks. Doxa, Tifara. And then hold the Pentecost splendor. The very first thing what Satan wants to give is kabod. To see that these people are not grown up into grammatical program, yet they would love to give up to their every thought in your body. And the second one, he talks about tifara. And who are this caliber of the people? They try to open up their mouth, renewing not with a genuine repentance to the Lord. They are very, very false men. No genuine repentance for the truth in the Lord. And then we look. As men whom you have known the character in the hell or in the earth. The word earth could be equivalent to be as hell. Because as long as Satan could touch anything on the earth, it cannot be for the glory of the Lord God. Therefore, he individually calls every believer to be his holy temple. And he maketh that in this temple, the earth, I will fill the glory of Lord God. And after whence the wickedness or such lies or such everything that maketh up to be against the glory and holiness of Lord God, when he wipes them out, once again as the word Eden meant to say pleasant, but now it will not be Eden, but it will be heavenly Jerusalem, he compares. That means Jerusalem, teaching of peace, establishment of peace. And the word of establishment of peace or teaching peace is nothing but to say these are that men of the caliber who have been era. And the word era or for yara, what you can look for Jerusalem, yara plus shalom, it meant to say you are erecting a structure, and that erection of the structure meant to say these people have lived a life of truth on the earth as witnesses, and they will enter into that heavenly Jerusalem, the new heaven and the new earth. And in the meantime, it will not be like the pleasant garden Eden. Eden meant to say pleasant, no pleasure. And you may think you'll be in the pleasurable people or this caliber or that caliber, simply forget. You'll be doing nothing there. So these people who have been there for the presence of Lord God the Father, they will be an established man, a man who have been proved on the earth for truth. They lived a life of truth. They genuinely lived a life of truth. Therefore, these were the men who have been beheaded. And the list has to be filled up, he said. Until then, I will wait, said the Lord God in the book of Revelation. And who they were, for the word of God, they were beheaded, they were martyred, because they lived a life of truth for truth, and they were witnesses for the truth. And Satan comes to give you glory. Like Mordecai was being told, bow down, and he says, no, I will not bow down before the pleasant, the word Haman meant to say pleasant, or the magnificent things, the pleasurable things. Bow down before me. Mordecai says no, and the word Mordecai is a little man, or the word will be worshipper of Mars. The word Mars over here, as the sun goes to reflect, the things pertaining to the light and the moon goes to reflect, the same thing when the sun glows up and the moon reflects. So it's compared to one of the planets over there, but little man, little Christ, he says no. No to the magnificent beauty of the world. Because he knew the true glory is when I become like a grammatical program. When I make up my every thought to be brought into captivity for my Christ. When I open up my mouth as a genuinely repentant person, I renew my thought process. Not like Judas Iscariot. I want to be a truly genuine person like the Simon the Cyrene who carried the cross of my Lord. The same day itself, the Roman centurion who was believing in Christ and he was been absolutely transformed. Such a true repentance. He wants such caliber of the man, not the false caliber of the man. Until the day you die, you have been given the privilege to transform yourselves, to think upon the word of Lord God as accurately as it has been needed. But dear brethren, you will find these people are not at all happy for such great word of God. Because when you look upon those characters on the earth, for example, you find the same person over there, we have been with him on the earth, and you can tell upon him, he is such a character, a characterless fellow. Will you not find the same things over there in the heaven, Lord? Will he not go to corrupt your name? Was he a witness for your truth? Was he obeying for your word? Was he really loving you? If he were really loving you, Lord, he would obey your mandates, but he did not do it. You called him to be your friend, but he was not even worthy to be praised. Another person is able to come to the heaven. You know what? A chance like Judas Iscariot has been given to everyone. Not to just have guilt remorse, but a true repentance. That's what he failed, and he hanged himself. Likewise, many people have been given the chance to repent, but they're having that guilty and remorse. And since they haven't able to repent and look upon the solidified thought process of Bible doctrine, many will be washed out from the heaven. Because you cannot find those straight the same characters of them, what you have seen them in the earth. Therefore he said, look upon the example of Apostle Paul. Earlier he was Saul, he persecuted the church ignorantly, knowing not. But afterwards he said, I am the chief of the chiefest sinners. And now he becomes a man of apostle, and he has been given the privilege to look into third heaven. And the man who said, walk like me, I follow Christ, imitate to be as children of God. Why? Because he knew now the process was the only one thing to make every believer to be perfect and complete in all wisdom and knowledge according to the terms and conditions of Bible doctrine in Christ. The things what we have. And yet, dear brethren, we people haven't able to look what is that glory. The true glory versus the false glory. The true glory when you become like a grammar program in making up your body to get every thought into captivity for Christ. The true glory if you can look. He teaches to us that they will have a truly genuine repentance in their thought process. They will make up their body to be a great expression of joy for the Lord because they get their every thought into captivity for Christ, because they will be like the friends of God. And now the church has been called above the friends to be the wife of my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Then how much you have to be? You know, the creation of man, when he made man, he hasn't made him a friend or a family. He gave him a suitable helpmate called to be the woman, his wife. Look into the order now. In the Old Testament, he said, for Abraham, he is my friend. In the New Testament, Lord and Savior Jesus Christ calls for us before the Holy Spirit of Lord God being given to indwell in us. In John 15, 14 and 15, you are my friends or fellow friends. Whatsoever man did you do, if you do them. And then afterwards, if you can look, he further teaches for us, from friends, you'll be my wife. The church is the wife of the Lord God, the suitable helpmate for the Lord God. In Isaiah 41:8, he had a mission for all the world to go be as a friend. But they sought for cheap substitutes. the man who did according to the standards of their idol worships, the cheap substitutes what they had. And now if we can look in the church age, we don't have such cheap substitutes for us. A one man, a right man, the woman, right woman will only respond to the right man. And that woman has to know how much he has to be in her soul to reflect. That's what the Isha will be for Eve. That's what the thinking of Christ will be for those people. Because they will be associated with such life in the Lord. And now not as a friend, but something great as a wife. And now the mission is, you have to make every believer to be conforming to the image of Christ. And by that, every believer meant to say what? The earth has to be with believers. Every human being who has breath in his nostrils has to become a disciple to the Lord. That's a great commission for us. That's why whenever you have your food before you eating, you look John 4:34 kept side of you. And Lord and Savior Jesus Christ teaches to us, my meat is to do the will of Lord God the Father. So, the purpose of Christ for us is to execute that will of Lord God the Father, and that will what we do should stand good for us. Because, dear brethren, the things what we have for us over here, it's very, very important. The will of Him, what He has given for us. The thought process of Him, what He has given for us. And that will, when He calls, is to make sure that everyone will look upon that great caliber when everyone will become like the image of Christ. And our duty is to perform that will. Therefore, having your food before you, remember John 4:34. Your meat is to do the will of Lord God the Father. Because you have to eat food. And remember, man does not live by bread alone, but by every word. Then why do you want to compromise your life? As Mordecai didn't go to compromise the day by day temptation for him before the magnificent things of the world. The day by day looking of your life. A chance to go and repent and change your thinking like Judas Iscariot and come back to the saving grace of the Lord. But the way you are acting guilty and remorse. Day by day genuine repentance has been seeking from you. When you look into the word of Lord God, a true repentance has been seeking for you. But not at all abiding in the truth for the Lord. No true repentance for Christ. Genuinely, there is no repentance for the Lord. You're looking for false splendors, false hopes, false dogmas. That's what Satan says. I will show you all the glory of the world. What you will have glory of the world. The thing where Satan is the prince of the power of this air. You think you will get anything truth from it. You will have deception like the way how Eve was been beguiled. In the glory Kavod you will find fake things. In the Tifara you will find fake things. Not a repentance. In the hope, splendor and honor you will find fake things. In everything you take, you will find fake, fake, fake. And Satan says to my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, bow down to me and give me the glory. As Mordecai didn't bow down to Hamad, so shall we, the church, also ought not to bow down for the pleasures of this earth. Because the things what we have in this earth is being headed by Satan. And Satan goes to show its glory. Satan goes to show its things pertaining to Tifera, a word meant to say that they have repented, but genuinely they haven't repented. They are still the same. They are feeling the guilty remorse things. Therefore, when if we can go back tomorrow to the heaven and look and understand what were the characters of them, In the later stages of his life, they changed to become good. They taught to help many people. But in reality, this is his character. He hasn't been washed in his soul and spirit by the pure word of God. Though Christ, O Lord our God, has washed all his sins away. He hasn't washed his thoughts. Lord and Savior Jesus Christ washed your sins, but your thoughts, you have to wash it with the word of God. Therefore, we have been said in Romans 12, 1, 2, and 3, don't be conformed to the world, but rather renew your thinking, renew your thought process. Enough of the thing you're having. And yet you have been still, not at all renewing your thought process, not washing your thoughts through the word of God, but you are still able to abide in the silly, stupid things of what we can call in simple words guilt, remorse, renewal, thought process. So you say, in a week you haven't come 3 times to the church, or we say in a month, 3 weeks you haven't come. So the fourth week you come and you say, Lord, blah, blah, blah. And you try to give him some bribe and tithe and say all the things. And Lord God will bless you with all of those things. No, dear brethren. This is remorse, guilt. This is a false glory. And sometimes on the earth, when the people are not in one accord, in one fear to the knowledge of Bible doctrine, we simply avoid them as a heretic by giving him first and second warning, and we avoid him because we don't want to change our thought process to the fear of Lord God. Neither we want to get diluted from such men who have such difference of opinion towards daily intake of Bible doctrine, towards protecting their soul and spirit, towards making an accountable thing to Lord God the Father. They don't have that. So it's better for us to avoid them. Because with fear and trembling, you need to work out your own salvation. The people who know the deliciousness of the Holy Spirit guiding and leading them, they will be wise ones. Their vigor and valor will be different because they have nothing but the truth upon their face. Their face shineth with the glory of the Lord God. Because they will be like the light of fire. No matter whatever it is, they will speak the truth. Whether they may, the other people who are listening would love to hear it or not, they will tell the truth. As John the Baptist was being beheaded for the truth, when he reprimanded Herod's activities, the woman and the wife, the same thing they tried to chop off his head, so shall be the truth for many people when their hearts will be pierced out. Their hearts will be pierced out. Because the people who tell the truth, they know the pleasure of the Holy Spirit, how delicious it is. It cannot go to make you sin, he said. That's what the Holy Spirit of the Lord God does. You cannot go to avoid taking up your daily intake of Bible doctrine. It cannot go to make you to be sinning against the Lord. It cannot. Because the way how you're going to sin against the Lord God, he says in simple terms, it cannot go to sin. It will not budge you to sin because your consciousness will not agree for it. Therefore, he said in 1 John 3:9, the people who have been born of the Holy Spirit of God, they cannot sin. That's very simple logic. They cannot sin. Why? The Holy Spirit of Lord God constraineth our hearts, teaching us that we are no longer associated with the harlot has one body, but we have been associated now with the Spirit, joined with the Lord God as one Spirit. Therefore, we come to have that one mind in one accord. And we love to talk the things pertaining to that deliciousness of the Holy Spirit of God. And therefore, what we do, we become like that greater Jews. Not just great Jews, but greater than those Jews. The praised ones, what we have, they're nothing. Because he calls us now not as friends, but as wife. And And the church age rapidly teaches to us that we are his wife. If Abraham was found in Isaiah 41:8 to be his friend, so that he walks in his word, the covenant cannot be cancelled with them, then how much more he makes up with his wife. Once joined together, no one can separate them. No one can put asunder what Lord God has joined. Then how much more the church has to be faithful. The church has to be so much as a great confidential weapon of the Lord in fulfilling the great desires of our Master, Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. How much the church is trusts. But you're looking into the worldly glory. You're not concentrating on the heavenly glory. In the worldly glory, people may go on to impress you. People may go on to talk about the things that which are pleasing to them. They may try to act as if they have been repented, but in reality they're having a guilt remorse. They try to give an expression of joy that they have changed, but tomorrow morning they will be the same again. But the heavenly glory says, once transformed from the darkness into the kingdom of his dear beloved Son as light luminaries, so you will be transformed completely. There will be no drama of remorse, guilt nature. It will be true repentance of your heart. And that joy, what we give to Lord God the Father, will be something superb, something awesome, which the world hasn't yet tasted from us. A truly genuine Christian. People would say, if you're a Christian, show me the sign and the wonders. That's what he said. The people of the past, of the Hebrews, they seek sign. The present, they seek wonders. But now I've called you to look into the word. And that word to be taught only by the power of Lord God, the Holy Spirit. The past, they failed. The present, we have something great to do. And yet, day by day, dear brethren, Mordecai, the way how he was being stressed to bow down, and yet he says no. Day by day, Satan comes to allure you with the glory, glory of the lust of flesh, glory of the lust of eye, glory of the pride of life. And you ought to say no for it. As Christ, our Lord, our God, didn't go to bow down before Satan and to look upon the glory of the world, so we also should look in the terms and conditions of this earth where, if you're not a grammatist program to the Lord, if you're not able to get every thought into captivity for Christ, then you think you've failed in that. If you're not able to renew your head repentant rather than remorse guilt, you've failed in that. If you're not able to give an expression of joy to Lord God the Father, greater love in this body, by getting every thought into captivity for Christ, looking upon you, your thoughts, the Father in heaven should give you great things. Thinking that, yes, there is a man for me on the earth who is able to stand in the gap. There is a man for me in the earth who is able to perform the will of the Lord. There is a man for me on the earth who is able to walk in the paths of righteousness. Only the redeemed will walk, a highway of the holiness. And I'm so happy for them. That's what he called the people of Jews in the past, but now he calls the church something greater. The Jews were friends, the church is wife. Which one will outweigh the more? Because you people have been abstracted in your life so that you can't understand the real meaning and the value of a wife. Therefore you find cheap substitutes for your wife pleasure. Not we are talking about the physical pleasure, we are talking about the companionship, what she can be for you. You find cheap substitutes in your hotel bars. You find cheap substitutes in your discotheques. At the most, you can make up your friends to be greater substitute for your wife, or you can make up your family and kids to be greater substitute for your wife. But a wife is a wife. She cannot be substituted. She is everything. Because she, if she's been responding accurately to the Lord, to his master, there can be no one to replace her. There will be no one to fulfill her either also. Only a right man can fulfill her by moving her unconscious mind. Her every part of the bowel will move a seat of emotions. And that's what the church is, in a deep love with one master. She doesn't have many boyfriends. As the affairs of the world today, they will find many boyfriends, cheap substitutes. These are no substitutes at all. Because you're having many women on the earth and many men on the earth, you think you'll have a best friend over here. Your best friend will be a big alcoholic bottle in your restaurants or bars. A cheap prostitutes for, you know, discotheques. You think they will be great for you, for your wife? No way. They cannot be. A wife is a wife. Therefore, Lord God, the Father, when it passed, makes a wife. And that wife has to respond to her mind in such a way that she is able to look upon the soul compatibility in his thinking, in his mentality, in his volition, in his emotion, in his thoughts and process, in his norms and standards, in his consciousness, in everything. She pleases the man very well, and the man will be very mad about her. She matches that soul compatibility, dear brother. She matches. You know what fools we are not to match the compatibility of the Lord's mind. We are really the fools. Fools to such an extent that we are not able to really recognize or understand the will of Lord God the Father in heaven. We are such a fools not to recognize the truth. Because when he said to the Jews as friends, he says to the church as his wife. And how much more wife shall be confidential to her master? But now today, what wife has become? She has become like a promiscuous, lying, treacherous woman. The church is also the same. There is no difference. Having every way you look to cheat her husband. Though she has got married to the Holy Spirit of God, she's able to enjoy her time with whom? With the ex-boyfriends, cheating the husband with the present boyfriends, thinking that the boyfriends can please her, thinking that the things what they have is absolutely different. So in each and everything you look, how they have been occupied with each other, how they've been able to look for each other, and they think they're really able to bond up in one soul. But in reality, they are going for adultery and fornications and prostitutions. But you know what Lord God does? He knows to find that caliber of the people who will be great loyal to him in the church age as well. Therefore, many are called. But the one who has taken the roots to the such extensions of the thinking that I don't want to be with the Holy Spirit of God, I want to make up my flesh to be my God and do the things of this God. That meant to say what? She doesn't want to be with her present husband, she wants to be with her boyfriends. And Lord God the Father would know how to filter you out, or how to choose that section or that caliber of the people who are really glorifying Lord God the Father by waiting upon Lord God the Holy Spirit. He knows that. And he clearly distinguishes them. And he kills them off. The people who are others, he says, you are not worthy to enter in. Though you may say, I will stand at the door and knock and say, Lord, Lord, open the door. Because in the heaven, you will never have to find the same people there again. The people, not for the sins what they have done against you, but for grieving and squelching and waxing and lying and resisting Lord God, the Holy Spirit, in spite of repeated warnings told for them, live a life of truth, don't live a life of lie, at the thought the life of lie is more pleasurable for them. In spite of repeated warnings given to them, Lord God the Father himself disqualifies them. Therefore he says in Revelation chapter 22 verse number 15, saying that the dogs, the idolaters, the sexually immoral people, the warmongers, the murderers, and the one who love and make a lie to be for them, to build up lie and to make love a lie, he said, they will not enter into the presence of the Lord God. Because the marvelous presence of Lord God demands nothing but truth, 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 your inward path. So he calls the church to be his wife, but the church has become a whore. How many people are walking in the spirit apart from, we can find them, less than 1%? As the terms and conditions of the Jews in the past for this endowment ministry of Lord God, the Holy Spirit was upon less than 2% of the people out of the entire 100%, like Eldath and Medath, an example what we stated. Only on kings, on the prophets, and the temple workers, how the Spirit of the Lord God was. So if you can look over in the present Christendom, only 1 or 2% of the people can be really genuine wife of the Lord. Remaining 98 to 99% of the people are cheaters. They are called to be the traitors. They are making up to be the enemies. They are going to be like the wolves. They will be widows. They will be prostitutes. They are not having the genuinity to come and pass the test as 365-day period of discipleship program to the Lord, Acts 11:26. Not coming to that process in the Lord. 365 days of discipleship program, how many people are coming to the church? How many people are making up to say, we will be the true disciples for the Lord, the trained disciples for a span of more than 1 year? They were called as Christians for the first time in Antioch. No one qualifies for that. You know, less than 1%, the way how the Jews were taken up by Lord God, the Holy Spirit, in controlling and doing their work. Likewise, over here in the churches also, you are not able to find that caliber of the people who will walk and talk the terms of Lord God, the Holy Spirit, and they will be also less than 1 or 2%. Because 2 or 3 have been gathered, that's where the church will filter up. Be careful, dear brother, not because of the sins what they have done. The sins is no longer an issue. After knowing Christ, ignorance of the knowledge of salvation, ignorance to walk in the fellowship of Lord God, the Holy Spirit, ignorance to represent the truth, ignorance to make up the life in the sphere of righteousness and holiness in the fellowship of Lord God, the Holy Spirit. Ignorance of such life has completely banned them out. And you don't want to look upon them in the heaven again. The way how the people sinned in Numbers chapter 14, or Numbers chapter 21 it has to be. And they make up the brass one. Anyone look upon that brass structure, the venom wouldn't have been poisoned the blood, they would be saved. Likewise, we don't want to look upon that caliber of the people wherewith we don't find that integrity for the truth in the Lord. We don't find that standards of truth in Christ. We don't want that caliber of the people. By looking upon them, our minds will go back for the disrespectable ways or thoughts they have done against my Yahweh. Because we will be like the light of fire to tear them out. Cross-check their soul, cross-check their head, cross-check their mouth. How they were in fake or false glory. And Lord God the Father knows very well, these will be the men who have not been qualified. Therefore he puts a list completely in Ephesians chapter 4. When he talks to that caliber of the people, he said, stop speaking lies to everyone. Speak the truth. That means if you are living a life of lie, if you are making up your life of lie, he said, you cannot be for me in the heaven. You have been kicked out from there. No excuse for it. You'll be kicked out from there. And now you may live a life of lie. And look in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, he said, love rejoices in the truth. And if Christ, the Lord our God, should love you, he wants truth in your inward parts, because he has delighted in you, he delivers you out from every trouble of this life. But where is the truth for you in your soul? Where is the truth for you in your thinking? Where is the truth for your life on this earth? Where is the truth? And what sort of a life we are living today on the earth? Where is the truth? In which place you can say you are truthful to the Lord, or in what manner you can say you are truthful to the Lord? Are you able to pay back your tithe of your time, 2 hours, 40 minutes every day in the fellowship of Lord God, the Holy Spirit? Are you able to make it up? Can you say that's the truth? Can you say, I've come to the church 365 days, and that's the truth? Can you say, Lord, I'm a trained disciple, the trained disciple for a span of 1 year, they've been called as Christians. That's the truth. Can you say that's the truth for you? Can you say Luke 9:23, every day carrying your cross and coming to me in the fellowship of Lord God, the Holy Spirit? And can you say, Lord, I am the truth over here for you? In which manner or in what your truth to the Lord, so that you can say your place cannot be canceled out from the heaven? Therefore, he says in Numbers, when he goes to talk a lesson, I think in Exodus, not Numbers, saying that any soul in chapter number 30, it has to be, that sinneth against me, him will I blot out. Because Moses pleads and says, Lord, if you're not putting them back, remove my name. And then what the word of Lord God teaches for us. He said, any soul that sinneth against me, I will blot it out. But now come up and go upon your journey. Any soul that sinneth against me. You look how much your soul is sinning against the Lord God. Sin, missing the mark, chatta. Measured by the knots, you will look how much you are differentiated from the demands and what you have achieved. The gap between them both is a sin. What are the demands and what have you achieved? What are the demands and what have you thought of? And you think your Christian way of life, it's a fake Christian way of life what you're living. This is not at all the Christian way of life, because you have been able to look upon lies. You can say, what is the lies? Translations you're looking, though in spite of this 21st century where we're able to make up our time in the smartphones for many interlinear texts and look and learn and read them and understand them as a pastor teacher, the pastor teacher doesn't have time to study them. Therefore, what he's coming and feeding you, he's daubing you with untempered mortar, so that now he's making you to sow to the wind and you're reaping war wind. And the Christians are becoming war Christians, not more, but war, W-H-O-R-E, war. Not M-O-R-E, but war dumb Christians. You're becoming sowing to the wind, not in the spirit, but fake and false doctrines, fake and false teachings, teachings which has not at all been found in the original Hebrew, Greek, and Aramaic. No exegia, my doctrine for you. And such fake things are impressing your Lord. And people are so happy for such fake things to be continued in their life. Such fake things are making you so pleasurable, isn't it? What's your life? Is it worth, at the cost of your momentary pleasure of life, you're losing out heaven in eternity forever? Therefore, he said, speak truth. You don't know what is the truth? Come and learn from the pastor, teacher, what is the truth. Join a church where the word of Lord God has been taught every day. There will be no greater business for a man on the earth than to renovate his thinking as per the terms and conditions of Bible doctrine. Because he called the Jews as a friend. He calls the church to be his wife. A wife of a church which can be pure as a chaste virgin to the Lord, as opposed only to one man. Not like the wife of a woman. Though being as a sacred one, she goes on to be friendly with all the people, practicing every manner of abomination, filth, prostitution, adultery, making up the boyfriends, making up all the things pertaining to them, but not able to make up their life to be pure as opposed to only one man in Christ. And Christ, our Lord of our God, doesn't want such church, who is a prostitute-oriented church, where the woman doesn't know the value of a true man. He doesn't want such church. He wants a church which is pure and true for Christ, who loves to know the deliciousness of the power of the Spirit. Stupid doesn't know the deliciousness of his right woman. And we, the church age, are not able to recognize the deliciousness of Lord God, the Holy Spirit, and become that caliber of the people where Christ, our Lord, our God, could really enjoy through our lives on this earth. Because you're still seeking fake glory, false glory. And such false and fake glory is pleasing you. And you're so happy in that you continue. But Mordecai didn't bow down. That's the sign of a true Jew. These are true worshippers of the Lord God. The word Jew meant to say praised. What a caliber it will be for them. Therefore they're called to be the real olive tree. We are called to be the wild olive tree, says Romans 11. We're engrafted to that real olive tree. But this wild olive tree has to transform itself day by day. But the real olive tree, they're not at all happy. And dear, dear brethren, the men who have been acquainted not to know the deliciousness of Lord God, the Holy Spirit, will be fools, he said. These will be the stupid ones. Therefore, he says in Proverbs chapter 19, in verse number 10, indeed, a servant to rule over the chiefs, how it will be, so he said, the people who shall be like the servants to me. I've given them the power of deliciousness to know the Holy Spirit of God, to rule like chiefs over the fallen angels. But these servants are trying to rule over the chiefs. And who are the servants? Who shall be true witnesses? Actually, they should rule over the chiefs. But what is happening? They're not able to rule over the chiefs. Why? Because they don't know the deliciousness of Lord God, the Holy Spirit given for them. The deliciousness has not been known. And it doesn't have that intelligence. It has been postponed. Why? Because of his sins, because of his ignorance, because of his arrogance. And you know how your beauty is passed out? Beauty is passed out because you sin. That's what he says over here. The word tifara again in Proverbs chapter 19, verse number 11. That means to say what? That which shall be your mouth in renewed thought process of the word of Lord God is passed over because of your transgressions. Why? Since you haven't had your intelligence has been postponed because of anger towards Bible doctrine. And dear brethren, today also if you can look and talk to some people and tell to them, this is wrong, don't do it. Their intelligence has been postponed because of the anger. They don't want to heed the truth. They want to correct the truth. And therefore what they become? Their glory is gone out because of the sins. The tifera is gone. Therefore they don't be like a ruler's over the chiefs, though they are servants. A servant, Doas, will be a faithful one for Christ. He will be ruler over the chief, he said. But this man will not be rulers. The reason why they can't be rulers is very simple. Because they don't find deliciousness in the power of the controlling, mentoring ministry of Lord God, the Holy Spirit. Then how come Lord God the Father can fulfill his work? That's the question. Why I've given such sort of long introduction is very simple. The Jews were called as friends, they failed. Says Isaiah 41, though he said, who is calling out, who is standing out? Then he said, who is really listening and responding to them? In Isaiah 41, in verse number 24 and 25, who is responding to them? No one. There is none that standeth, there is none that heareth. Now he calls the church to be his wife, but the wife has become a whore. Forsaking the true Lord of a God, they're sick. They look upon the old sin nature activities to be more pleasure like the dog which goes back to its own vomit. The same old sin nature life. And they become a whore and they think they don't know the deliciousness of the Holy Spirit of God because they haven't tasted it. If you have tasted the good gift of Lord God the Father, you'll recognize what a power it will be for Christ. You've tasted it. You haven't tasted, so you cannot be ruler over the princes. They are called to be a servant in the Lord God. You haven't known what will be the ruler over the princes. And then what happens? Your intelligence has been postponed because of what? Because of your anger. Why anger? When we tell the truth, people don't want to listen to the truth. That causes them to be anger. They postpone their intelligence. Up to what? Till the day they die. Up to what? The day they die. You know what? till they could make up their soul not to be cleansed. Less than 1 or 2% of the people will make up to the heaven. That will be the beautiful church. A church from every kindred, every language, every nation. There'll be at least 2 or 3. Don't worry. And remaining all, they will fall for such tifara. Remorse, guilt, actions, no repentance for truth. A man who truly repents for truth will never go to sin again. But their conscience has been seared up for sin to such an extent they don't understand the life of truth in the Lord. They don't learn the life of truth. They don't understand the life of truth. So, dear brethren, we look. Because of your anger, you're postponing your intelligence. That which shall be prudence, that which shall be your understanding, that which shall make you to be a grammateus program to the Lord God, having a perfect mind in understanding the Lord's word. That's what he says in Colossians 1:24-29. Presenting every believer to be perfect and complete in all wisdom in the presence of Lord God the Father. That mind is God. That sakel is God. That prudence is God. That circumspect mind of thought is God. Why? Because of your anger. Why you get anger? You are not able to accept the truth. That's why you're not able to get into the truth. And since you're short of truth, you know what happens? Your glory departs because of your sin. And you know what? When that glory departs, though you may go to your millennia dollar of beauty parlors to make up yourselves, you'll never get back that glory. That glory is gone. And look, day by day, how much of that glory has been gone every day. Because of your transgression, because of your sin. The glory is gone, dear brethren. No. How much hard you try, you will not get. You know why? First, you should let go your anger when the truth has been told. Your intelligence should come back to your senses and say, yes, this is the truth. There is no point of getting anger in it. Because truth is bitter. In the case of John the Baptist and Herod, when John the Baptist reprimands Herod, he knows very well what is happening there. But the one, his brother's wife, she's not happy, she's in anger. So glory departs because of your sin. And people nowadays are not at all happy to take the truth. Because they don't want, because they think what they've done is the best, but we know very well it's not at all the best. It demands the truth, not truth. People still add on for transgressions. Not true. People will add on for transgressions. The glory has been departed. They're not at all happy for it. And that they would say, we are so great, we are so fantastic, we are this, we are that, we are blah, blah, blah. The world may give you a lip praise because they look outward appearances. But the Lord God looketh inward. And since Lord God looketh inward, he says, you're called to be a servant, but rule over the chief man. But you're not able to rule over the chief. Why? Because you don't know the deliciousness of the power of Lord God, the Holy Spirit, indwelling in you. So Mordecai didn't bow down as a true Jew for the magnificent things of the world. So Christ, O Lord of our God, didn't bow down for the allurement of Satan. It says, bow down to me, I will give you all the glory. And that glory which has been filled up with lies on this earth, how you can enjoy that glory? A glory of no grammateus program, a glory of not able to get every thought into captivity for Christ, a glory where your thought process is not at all been renewed with true repentance, but it goes to be like a remorse guilt method, a glory where there is no great expression of joy in its body because of the thought process to be brought every thought into captivity for Christ. Do you think you have that hod? Do you think you have that tifera? Do you think you have that kabod? You're trying to tell to the Lord you will be there in the heaven. You think heaven is so easy to come in? Revelation 23 chapters teaches to us first entrance into the tree of life. So that what they do now, hidden manna. So what they do now, after the hidden manna, they come to look upon the sun, it's like a morning star to the Lord. Then what they do? They gradually they make up their name to be in the book of life. No wise to be casted off. Because we have the seven steps over there. The one who overcometh first, he sees that his name has been recorded in the book of life. In Revelation chapter 2, for the first church, he said that to the angel of Ephesus, he said, tree of life he goes to give you, the Zoe life. And to the people of Smyrna, he says, be faithful until the end, and he overcomes the second death, no fear of the second death. And then he goes to talk about the angel of Pergamos, and he says to them that these people, when they come, they will be like having to take hidden manna. The point over there in verse number 70, they're looking for hidden manna. The fourth angel will be like the morning star. The fifth church, what we look over there, he emphasizes, they will be like the caliber of the people who are walking worthy to me, and no wise I will remove their name out of the book of life. You have a step-by-step process to get qualified. Just don't think your heaven is so easy after believing in Christ, you will get into there. There is no chance at all in those terms. So, dear brethren, we look over here to learn the lesson which is saying that this hidden manna, after the concept of this hidden manna, we are able to look and understand the terms which has been given for us, the book of life. But rather, he says, I will confess his name before my Father and before his angels. And then for the church of Philadelphia, he said, the people who are able to do up the things that make up the things pertaining to the earth, he would say, I will no wise take away a crown, but I will hold fast for you to take up, to look into the crown, and I will make up to be as a pillar in the temple of the living Lord of God. Then I will write a new name upon you. And this is for the church, what he says over here at Pergamos. And then he comes to the last church, Laodicean church. And here he tells to them, I will make you to sit in my throne. And you think so easily you're going to get into heaven? It's not at all possible, dear brethren. Just don't think the things will be so easy, so casual. The things which have been given for us demands the truth in the Lord every day. It's not so easily possible for you, and you think your characters which are for a wife, which are dead against the word of truth, those characters will qualify you. Just look and examine how much traitor you are. Or how much your activities are like that imperious, warish woman. How much of your activities are just like treacherous woman, lying, deceiving the husband. How much you will find just that look. And you think this will make up into the heaven? No way. The characters of them will influence others. Therefore, remove that plague from you. He says, after first or second admonition, such heretics, tell them to correct. Afterwards, throw them out. The same thing what we read in 1 Corinthians 5, the man who was having affair with his own mother. There can be no worse caliber of the people than the Corinthians in the church age. Worst sins of all time. Throw them out. For a sign, for a time, for a season, so they can repent and come back, because eternity is more valuable than the earth. He said, correct it through the word of God. I have washed your sins by the blood of God. Now correct your thoughts by the word of God. That should be the theme for us. As long as we reside in this flesh, that should be the theme for us. Correct yourselves through the word of God. Your thoughts, because I have washed your sins by the blood of God. And what we are lacking today in our pulpits, we are lacking the true word of God to cleanse, the true agent which goes to cleanse us out. In India, we have these ISI companies which meant to say, international standard companies or Indian standards companies of industries. You know, they have this badge, ISI mark. We call always the ISI mark. And the first they come into a product and they look whether it is a China product or India product. And if it's an Indian product, they want to see where is the ISI mark. And they say it's genuine. And afterwards they go to purchase it, or they look into the review of it. And they say under the standard testing tools, they have found that it has been worth enough to buy, so they buy it. If not, they throw it out. Likewise, for every word of God, what it has been taught every day in your pulpits, check for the ISI mark, a mark of genuinity. And that mark of genuinity is found only in the original Hebrew, Greek, and Aramaic. If the pastor teacher doesn't go to study the word of Lord God from the original Hebrew, Greek, and Aramaic, then make sure he's running his ministry for his belly. For some pieces of bread or for some handful of barley, diluting the glory of my Lord on the earth. He's adulterating it. And he's making up his life like a woman who has multiple lovers and not exposed to one man as a truth in Christ. He maketh her to be like a multiple lovers affair. Not a never to Christ. Not a never to truth. Multiple affairs. And such men are more for us in our pulpits today. So dear brethren, if you haven't known the deliciousness of the power of Lord God, the Holy Spirit, then he says you are a fool, you are a stupid. I've called you to be like a servant to rule over the princes, but you have been ruled or trampled down by Satan rather than you trampling down Satan under your feet, says Romans 16:20. Therefore, he says all the time, and the truth has been told, you lose out your intelligence because you should lose your glory by your sins. When the truth has been told, to accept the truth, to accept it, not in anger, but in prudent way of life, and understand and think upon that and learn the word of truth, your life would have been something different and marvelous. But a life is not accepting the truth. It's not at all living in the life of truth. Then he says, your glory is gone, tifara is gone. What will he do with that tifara which doesn't have eternity impact? Would he love to please women? Would he love to please men? Would he love to please the things on the earth? Only fools will do that, and cine actors will do that. You know why they do it? To impress you. But they don't have the real glory of Yahweh shining upon them. Therefore, looking upon that way of life, what they're living, what they're reigning, what they're performing, you can clearly understand up to what extent the people of the earth are making up their life for lies on this earth. Up to what extent they're able to make up, just look. And dear brethren, day by day, though Haman wanted Mordecai to bow down, he didn't. Though Satan wanted by showing all the glory to Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, he didn't. You are not even knowing the impact of this angelic conflict in your life, and you're simply bowing down for some pieces of bread or for some handful of barley for the pleasures of this earth. How would you be there? How would you be? Or how come you can be? Because, dear brethren, all the days of this life, you're not able to make up your thinking for Christ. And what will you find? A life against the truth is great. You may call it and think it is a great, cunning way of life we are living to the Lord, saying that we are really worshippers of God. But Lord God the Father is seeking such true worshippers who worship Him in spirit and in truth. They will be present tomorrow as a witness to the Lord in the heaven. And you may think by your hypocrisy, you may think
By the standards of your ways of life, you're worshipping the Lord God, but Lord God, the Father, knows your heart very well what you are. You may not know for your own self, because you may not examine your own self. You may not make known of your hypocrisy life to other persons. But you will recognize that in the presence of Lord God the Father, every single iota and carat of the word of truth has to be taught. And if that hasn't been made or that hasn't been performed, have they tie without looking or recognizing the value of this truth? You know, how much has been given for us, how much has been expected from us, and yet we are still not even qualified to be as friends of the Old Testament. Far less we are called to be the honor of wife of the Lord. Beginning with the church age, he says in Ephesians 2:7, one upon the another, he wants to show you as a monument for the ages to come that this people lived a life of truth for me, the fellowship of Lord God, the Holy Spirit, in spite of being a strange seed to me, before the foundation of the world, have chosen them for me to be holy and blameless for my work. Such a great earnest desire Father in heaven has towards his son through his wife, because he glorifies us through his word, calling us to sanctify our lives through his word, and yet still we are not able to look upon the things pertaining to his word on this earth. It's not worthy. The life what we are living is not at all worthy. Don't ever think living a life of lie you can make your soul not to sin against the Lord. What you are in and out, what you will be, or what you were in the past, or what you will be in the future, Lord God the Father knows everything about you. Don't try to think you can go to mock or kid him. He knows everything about you. Better be naked. Gala exposition of your truth. Better be naked. Look into the life of truth. Better be naked. Don't try to be something else which is not there for you. Better be naked. The word naked is gala in the Hebrew. That meant to say erect a structure for discipleship program. Better be that to the Lord, rather than looking upon a life of lie and not able to perform the desired demands of Christ through his word, which has been given for us in this church age. So, dear brethren, how many days more? The thinking of your process which has been there on this earth, how many days more? You still want to reject the truth, how many days more? If you're still not able to make up your life for Christ in truth, how many days more? Because, dear brethren, day by day, your actions, your breaths, your thoughts will be considered. If these actions and thoughts in your breath are not able to perform to the glory of the Lord, then you have a chance tomorrow again, if you can look in your breath, in your nostrils, you have a chance to correct yourselves. Look upon that. That means Lord God the Father is still giving a chance of grace to repent, not to show forth your remorse guilt, so that he can find joy by our body on this earth, because we get every thought into captivity for Christ. And that every thought what we get into captivity for Christ will be the splendor and the glory for Yahweh. And yet, if you are still not able to live such a life of truth in Christ, what's this life worth for you on this earth? You'll find nothing of a marvelous thing on this earth, because your life demands the truth. When you don't know the truth, the soul cries, because it hasn't been fed even that day also the truth of the word of God. Your soul weeps because it belongs to the Father in heaven. It hasn't been fed with the word of Lord God. And the things which do not belong to you, Lord God, the Father looketh into an account to take care of it. Then how does he give for you in his unrighteous manner? That which belongs to you, said the Lord. And day by day grow up in grace, meditate upon the word of Lord God, day by day the fellowship of Lord God, the Holy Spirit. And learn the truth, so that the truth alone can set you free. So the Jews failed as friends to Yahweh. The church is also failing abruptly to be the wife of the Lord, rather than exposed to one husband as chaste virgin. The church has become a great prostitute, having multiple lovers. And who shall take it? Even in the church he goes to filter. Those men who are genuinely having the Tavetav mark of the Lord God, as we read that in Ezekiel 9:4. The zeal of the Lord God, so that these men have passed the test of the Lord God of Revelation 2 and 3, the seven stages. And they will be really glorifying Lord God, because they are fearing Lord God to the praise of his glory in his grace. Because they love to have heaven as their abode rather than hell. They love to show forth that glory in the flesh rather than departing that glory because of the transgressions what they have done, as being foolish ones not to have intelligence in them. So, dear brethren, which way you want to go, you decide. Life is too short, and the responsibility laid down upon our shoulders is too large. So, which way you want to go, you decide, as we shall come back and continue tomorrow. As Lord God, the Holy Ghost, leadeth us to the praise of his glory in his matchless, marvelous, infinite, divine, glorious grace. So with our head bowed and eyes closed, the closing moments being dedicated to those of without Christ, without hope, and without eternal life. Inaudible telling to Lord God, the Father, in the privacy of your soul, that you believe my Christ, my Lord, my Rock, my Savior, that's the moment itself you shall have this eternal truth. This eternal truth, for so very simple, believing Christ, you shall be saved. Whereas for the believer, the grace must grow up in grace and in the knowledge of Bible doctrine, wherewith you shall learn to acquire to possess to know the truth, and the truth will set you free. Whereas for the pastor teachers, the grace must carry Sothan Lagan, herald the word in season and out of season, because the Dharmatma witnesses faith have been called. The number one Dharmatma witnesses in willing trinity, for the Bible in our hands, and number two Dharmatma witnesses or hearers. If there are no hearers, dear brother, not what besides nature, the entire angelic host will be witnesses, and whatsoever work, our work is to rightly divide the word of truth, no matter how the chips may fall. So which way you want to go, dear brethren, you decide, as we shall come back and continue tomorrow. As Lord God, the Holy Ghost, leadeth us to the praise of his glory in his matchless, marvelous, infinite, divine, glorious grace. Infinitely divine Holy Father, being grateful and thankful, Lord, for this great and unique privilege which are given to fellowship with thee through thy word, to understand that if Mordecai couldn't bow down before Haman, how much the church should bow down before the glory of the world, which is fake, rather than looking upon the true glory of yours and shining forth in this body to the world to understand that Lord and Savior Jesus Christ alone reigneth forever and forever. By filling the earth of this flesh, what we have, the divine holy temple, with your glory. And that glory is the exegetical Bible doctrine, O Lord, which we need to learn. Help us to understand that accurately. Help us to be a true witness for your word, rather than mingling up our lives with such liars who are calling to be as exposed to one husband, but in reality, O Lord, the so-called Christians are prostitutes to the core, making up the universal church to be filtered up under the terms of sowing to the wind and reaping the whirlwind. So, Father, being grateful and thankful, it's a privilege to understand your mind, the fellowship of Lord God, the Holy Spirit. We pray the mentoring ministry of Lord God, the Holy Ghost, to enlighten, challenge, and to bless us by the message of yours, to the praise of your glory, in your matchless, marvelous, infinite, divine, glorious grace. In Christ's matchless, peerless, gracious name, we pray, Father, being grateful and thankful for this great revelation which thou hast given for us to understand your mind, we pray that the mentoring ministry of Lord God, the Holy Ghost, challenge us and equip us and enlighten us to the praise of your glory in your grace. In Christ's name we ask, Holy Lord. Amen.